Hello children, I welcome you all once again to your English class. I hope you all are doing good. Children, for today's video lesson, we are going to start a very beautiful poem because it's with the same name, Beauty. Yes, children, so now this, tell me one thing. Do you find flowers pretty? Do you think flowers are pretty? Do you think flowers are pretty? Do you think mountains, nature, chair, tables, whatever we see around us is beautiful? Don't you think so? Because I feel that when you look at your surroundings, when you are happy with it, okay, then you can find beauty in almost everything. Now tell me, is beauty only external? Like if you see a beautiful person and if you see a withered flower, if you see a flower in full bloom, what would you enjoy? What would you think that is beautiful? You would think that a blooming flower is beautiful, right? No one tries to keep the withered flower, right? The flowers which has withered, which has torn, which has worn out, or which is dead. No one likes those things which are dull or ugly. But sometimes beauty is not just external. We will read this beautiful poem and understand what is the poet trying to tell us. Okay, so our first line, beauty is seen in the sunlight. Okay, if you are an early riser, you must have seen the sun rising, and yes, it is in the sunlight. When it's continuously raining, realize the beauty of it, okay? When it's continuously raining and you are like tired of the rains, you no longer want the rain because the rain is like feeling all the roads, all the drainage, and like there's continuous downpour, right? You are not enjoying it. Now what would you appreciate at this time? A warm, beautiful, shining sunlight, right? So there is the beauty of sunlight. Now the trees, the birds, corn growing and people walking, yes, in their fruits of hard work, in the trees, okay, in the birds, when there's sunlight, you might have seen lot of trees and lots of birds in the sky when you wake up, right? Especially it's either in the evening or in the morning, okay, during sunrise or sunset, okay, you will find that nature is at its best, okay? Now see, corn growing and people working. Corn is actually the cereals, not the TV cereals. Cereals, I am referring to these cereals, okay, which are eaten like grains, okay, these are also grains. Corn, maize, all those things are our cereals, right children? So now, or dancing for their harvest. Now, do you see any farmer cutting crops and enjoying their harvest season? It's like so joyful moment for them, and when you watch them dance, you watch them beautifully soaking in their happiness, you are filled with joy, right? You are overjoyed just by watching them happy, right? Watching them smiling. Okay, now beauty is in the eye of the beholder. You might have heard this very famous proverb, very famous line, quotation, okay? So, beauty lies in the eyes of the beholder. Such a beautiful line this is. What do you think it means? It means that there is beauty in you, within you. When you appreciate the things around you, when you are happy from within, you find happiness and beauty in everything. Yes? So now it is the attitude of the person. Okay? You will see that beauty is everywhere. Okay? Now it can be seen in the sunlight, it can be seen in the trees. I have already explained you the first stanza, like five line stanza. So you cannot see a proper you will not be able to see a proper rhyme scheme there, but it's very irregular. Okay, we don't have a proper rhyme scheme here. Beauty is heard, okay, in the night. Okay, I found one rhyming thing. So see the second line of your first stanza, sunlight and night. Beauty is heard in the night. Yes, wind sighing, rain falling, okay, or a singer chanting. You can see that walking, chanting. Yes, anything in earnest, earnest, sincere and honest conviction. Now what does these lines mean? Okay, what does these lines here mean? Here they are saying, the poet is trying to say, beauty is a thing to be felt. Okay, we cannot see beauty with our naked eyes. If you want to see beauty, if you want to experience beauty, you need to feel it. Okay, one can listen to it. When you hear a melodious voice, you say, what a beautiful voice, right? You say it. Did you touch it? No. Can you see it, the voice? No, but you felt it, right? So, and you exclaimed that it's beautiful. That means you have heard it and it pleased your senses. Okay, so now when night falls, you might have, I think you're so busy nowadays, we are so busy, we don't wait, we don't stop and look, right? We don't observe. Like in the night time, even the insects, the night insects, the night animals which come out only during the night, they are continuously making some noises. We do not have time to pay attention to them because we are too busy with our mobile phones, with television sets. Okay, we are always engrossed with all those unnatural sound. But the night also brings with it own smell, own fragrance, okay, and own like feel, own voices, own noises. Yes, wind sighing. So when wind blows, it has a sigh. It has some kind of, as if it's breathing out, it's exhaling, it's sighing. And when rain falls, there is also music to it. Some people really enjoy rain. I do it. So I think we all enjoy rain, but not like it shouldn't keep on downpouring, right? It shouldn't keep on pouring. So we enjoy only sometimes. Now we know here we can see, you can also hear or you can also experience beauty when a singer is chanting anything in earnest. Okay, anything earnest means, children, what earnest means here? With a great dedication. When someone sings with great love, with great dedication, then the sound is melodious. When you are doing some work with all your honesty, with all your dedication, okay, there is the beauty. Okay, now beauty is a thing to be felt. I told you this. You will always find honesty and dedication in a person. Okay, you may find it. But when you learn to appreciate it, you realize the true beauty of it. External beauty, the physical appearance, has nothing to do with beauty. Okay? With something looking lovely, you are not only to consider the physical features, physical appearance, but you need to consider the honesty, the dedication, the love. Yes, children. So from this we know that the writers want to say that we need to involve in nature. Okay, we want to engage ourselves with nature so that we can get in tune with it and we can find beauty everywhere. Okay, because nature is the only source for our happiness. We can only find true happiness in nature around us, in our family, in nature. Okay, so now let's move to the next one. Beauty is in yourself. I told you this line, you can see. Beauty lies in the eyes of the beholder. Beholder is someone who looks, right? So beauty lies in the eyes of the beholder is a beautiful quotation. And from there, we can see that the poet is also asserting, he is also saying that beauty is in yourself. It is in us, okay? Good deeds, happy thoughts. You have to do good things. Deed means work, right? Good acts. Right? So deeds means acts. Acts means your work, your job, okay? Everything, not just professionally, whatever you do in day-to-day life. So happy thoughts, yes? When you are doing good to others, you are naturally happy. You are very happy. You don't need to stress, you don't need to bother because you know you have helped everyone, you have done good things. So you are always content, you are always satisfied, right? So now that repeat themselves. Okay, these happy thoughts, good deeds, when you get habituated to do good, okay? Whenever you are trying to do anything bad, when you are trying to do anything wrong, you are always shaken by your conscience. Your heart will never allow you to do it. So you are always with that happy thought. You are always repeating those good acts. Your happy thoughts are in complete loop, okay? It's happening continuously. In your dreams, okay? You know what? People say that whatever we think, whatever we are doing, we become those things. Okay, in our dreams also we see those things which we are constantly thinking about. So here also the poet is saying that when our thoughts are happy, when we are doing good things, we are always sleeping peacefully. Okay, we are always getting dreams and we are getting happy dreams, right? Now in your work and even in your rest. See, this is so beautiful line. So you are always at peace with yourself. With this, when you are doing some good act, when you are thinking nicely, when you have your happy thoughts, when you are not thinking evil of anyone, then my dear children, that time you are beautiful. Okay? During those moments, children, there is the beauty in you. Okay? The beauty is not outside, it's just internal. It's very internal within you. So realize that you have to do good. You have to think good so that whatever you do, whenever you are working and whenever you are at rest. Rest here can mean two things, children. We know we are, see this two things, children, here. It can mean, it has literal meaning as well as internal meaning. So work and rest. You know that God has created us, sent us on this planet to do some work, right? For a purpose, He sent us on this earth. We need to fulfill all our duties and then die. Because we are mortals, so we need to realize this, that this body is destructive, okay? So we have to constantly work, right? Then again, children, we have rest. Rest can mean two things. Rest can mean just a proper rest, like after a day's hard work, you can go and rest. And after your whole life's work, you can go and take rest in death, right? Because the only place where human beings can find a peace is in death, right, children? So done with our poem, there is no more. Now children, we will move ahead with writing of the meanings, okay, because this is very short chapter that did not take much time. Let's finish our meanings and then we will move ahead with question answers. So the first word here is number one, children, is corn. Okay, let me write the meaning of it. It's the chief cereal crop. Crop of wheat. So all these grains, wheat, oat, barley, maize, etc. Yes, number two now, we have harvest. The time of the year. When the crop is ready. Number three, sign. It means sound of a deep. A deep breath or exhale taken out of deep breath or exhale taken out of relief. Yes, number four now, chanting. Chanting is singing. Next, we have deeds. Acts. Number six, we have repeat. You know this, children, repeat is something which happens again and again. Happen again and again. Yes. We are done with the meanings. Please take a screenshot. Okay. And if it's visible to you, so here we have this. I think this side is more clear. So with this, children, we are done with the meanings. Now let's move ahead with working with the poem part. Okay, children, now let's get started with the question answers, working with the poem part, that is on page number 55. The poet says, beauty is heard in dot dot dot. It is the line from the poem. Can you hear beauty? Add a sound that you think is beautiful to the sounds the poet think it's beautiful, are beautiful. The poet Shelley said, heard melodies are sweet, but those unheard are sweeter. What do you think this means? Have you ever heard a song in your head long after the song was sung or played? Sometimes it happens, children, that we hear some songs but we remember it throughout because the melody is so beautiful, okay? If you ever read The Solitary River, you will understand the same thing happened with the poet, okay? So that's a beautiful poem indeed. And this beauty poem is actually beautiful. Now let's write the answer to this question, okay? So what do you think is beautiful? I think, see the chirping, you heard it? The chirping of the birds. You children can choose to decide what you like, what voice or what melodies, what songs or what sound you enjoy. You can use your own thing. The chirping of the birds, okay? I enjoy also the movement of the sea waves, the sound of the sea waves. Sea waves. Yes. You can write a lot of it. Okay. Are some sounds which are beautiful. I think this pen has become fainter. Let me change it. So yes, this is number one. Walking with poem. Now we have been asked about that two lines. What does it mean? So what does it mean? What does the poet want to say there? The poet. Poet says that. Says that her melodies or songs, are sweet and pleasant to the ears. But the melodies or the songs we had heard long back. Melodies or the songs we had heard long back is even sweeter in our memories. When we can could hear it no longer. Yes, children, this is the answer to our first question. I hope you can see it. Yes, okay. So this is our answer, first answer. Now, if the board is shining, let me do a certain thing. Maybe this can work. No, it's not working. So maybe this would help. Yes. So here it is. The chirping of the birds, the sound of sea waves, etc. You can add your own versions. You can add your own melody. So the chirping of the birds, the sound of sea waves are some sounds which are beautiful. The poet says that heard melodies or songs are sweet and pleasant to the ears, but the melodies or the songs which we had heard long back is even sweeter in our memory when we could hear it no longer, when we can hear them. Okay, let me do it. Let me use them here. Then hear them no longer. Okay, children. So this is about our first answer. Now we will move ahead with the second question. Read the first and second stanza of the poem again. Note the following phrases: corn growing, people walking or dancing, wind sighing, rain falling, a singer chanting. Okay, these could be written as corn that is growing, people who are working. Can you rewrite the other phrases like this? What do you think the poet uses? Why do you think the poet uses the shorter phrases? Now, here are some more examples. Let us give him the examples. The questions we are being asked, we have to answer it. So, number two. Okay, you can see this. Now, here are some more examples. Of such phrases. Phrases like stream flowing, yes, then we have wind blowing, children, laughing, mob, shouting, yes, so we have these examples, etc. Now, why does the poet use these phrases, this kind of phrases? Because it is giving musical rhythm to the poetic lines. I think the poet had used short phrases to give a musical rhythm to the poetic lines. Yes, children. So here are some more examples of such phrases: stream flowing, wind blowing, children laughing, mob shouting, etc. I think the poet had used short phrases to give a musical rhythm to the poetic lines. Okay, children. Now we have one more question. Find pictures of beautiful things you have seen or heard of. This, children, I cannot help with it. You will have to find the beautiful pictures. That means the idea of your beauty, what things you find beautiful, you have to write it. Okay, now we will move ahead with the next question. You will have to write a paragraph about beauty. Here, use your own ideas along with ideas used in this poem Beauty. Okay, children, with this we have finished our lesson. I hope you enjoyed the beauty of the poem Beauty. Okay, and you try to appreciate everything around you and find beauty in everything around you. Okay, children, find and look for beauty everything around you. because everything is beautiful when you are happy, when you are doing good deeds, when you are acting nicely. So everything around you is very beautiful. On this note, children, I'll take your leave. We will meet in another video lesson with another chapter. Till then, please take care of yourself. Bye-bye.